Hello everybody and welcome back to FTB Skies Let's Play. I am finishing up with my create stuff. I went ahead and added a bit more, so I did discover that adding a large cogwheel and like two small ones to get to this does fill it up good enough. I did go ahead and add the extra size to it. As long as it has the right amount of water and heat, it's not going to run out. It's just not going to fill it up completely with water because it's going to burn off more than it's consuming. That's fine. So I went ahead and added some more steam engines because I am going to go ahead and get my sifters and all of that ready. So the way that I'm going to end up doing this is I'm probably going to have like my crusher wheel down here, and then like my sifters up there that are gonna feed into a system that then crushes stuff, comes down here, cleans it, smelts it, all that fun stuff. I may not actually need the crusher wheel. I'm still trying to figure that part out. It doesn't get me much more, because like I said, there is really no ore doubling and stuff like that, but it'll get me chances of doubling some stuff and could potentially get me some other resources. So like if I just crush raw iron, all it gives me is one crushed raw iron, so there really may not be a point to that. The only other way would be able to turn it back into iron ore, which a combiner can do that. So I would need to take like stone. It's a big thing to be able to like, it would be way too much. Let me just put it that way. It would be way too much to be able to then get it doubled. Like it's, cause then that iron clump is gonna, it's way too much. If I can get there eventually, great. If you guys in the comments know of ways to do it easier, great. But I think right now my plan is going to be put my sifters back up here like that. I'm gonna have something that's gonna come out and just power all of them, and then those are going to feed out with item pipes. I think there's some kind of item transfer pipes in create. If not, there's at least the conveyor belts and like the mechanical arms and all of that. Or I can just hopper it onto... Or no, wait, it shoots. That's what it is. And that is actually one of the quests. So shoots and smart shoots. So to make a shoot, it's just iron, iron, iron. So I need... it makes four, so that I need like one extra than four. So... let me see. So four, so it's one, two, three. I'm gonna take one out, put two down. It is a little bit faster than it was originally, but eventually once we get like enough resources that I want to actually make a legitimate like blaze burner setup, then we'll do that. So I need to make a chute, which is the two iron here and the one in the middle. That makes me four chutes. So those four chutes can go one, two, three, four. And then eventually I will put a conveyor belt underneath this, which I could probably go ahead and do. So this was just a proof of concept, so I am going to take this off for now because I can put these higher up. So there's a chance I could probably take a gear, put it right here. Can I rotate you? I thought I could. Yeah. Okay, so that's that. Then I need probably a larger gear that's gonna stick out, let's say like that. Bring some shafts down. Probably another gearbox if I was a betting person. So, for that, I'll need some more gears. We which let's just go ahead and do that. And then gearboxes, plural? No, okay. So you will go vertical and go here. Then I can take my steam engine here. And I do need some more shafts because I just used that up. Is gonna go here and here, and then that gets my that going, so that actually is sifting rather quickly, so that's awesome. I can maybe bring this whole system up one more, but that isn't really important. And then I just need like maybe down here. I'm just gonna do that for now. Does that make it faster? Not really. Okay. But what I could do. Not sure. So I'm gonna need a shaft. All this stuff here. That can connect to that. And then I'm pretty sure any item that falls in here is gonna fall out. So let me test that by just throwing a stack of gravel into one of these sifters. Let me grab my andesite mesh or amethyst mesh that I have four of, and I have enough to make a fifth, but I'm just gonna do the four for it right now. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And eventually one of these does have to be re-waterlogged. But let me just throw that in there. That's going pretty quick. Oh, of course I put it on the one that I didn't put a chute on. Ya boy. Es muy stupido. I don't even know where I am anymore. Like, something messed up my brain. I can put those away. I don't know how I ended up with two of those. I need to go back and rewatch the footage. That can go away. So then I can pick up you. And you. I'm gonna take the gravel out of that. I can't just put it in there, can I? That is now on the conveyor belt. So how do I get you off the conveyor belt? Empty hand. Alright, so now this one has a chute under it. So now I can take you and do that, and then I think it'll pull out from the chute. Yes. But that chute does need to be consistently moving. And I can do that. Not like that. So this needs to be moving somehow. And I need to do it quick before I lose all of those items. I'm just gonna kinda shove you here for now. And will it go in there? Yes, it will. Okay. Alright. So you can actually be rotated. Which doesn't give me much. Or hear me out. You here, you here. And then one more belt. Connecting you. This is interesting. But that does work. So we're good there. We're getting a lot of resources. It just needs to then be funneled out. And the ores need to be washed, or at least just smelted on a... It needs to, like, have fire blowing from a fan or lava blowing from a fan. I just need a way to... get that moving. And that is a perfect way to do so. Awesome. And it's going in the right direction. So, have that go that way. Then I can probably put one more here and just connect. Connect you to here, and then that covers this whole thing. And I'm just going to put you here for now. And we may not worry about this fourth one. Just like that. And I can just pop you out. Perfect. Alright. So now, the only problem is that I'm probably going to need... I know that there's like tunnels and funnels and stuff like that. That can divide. So I need... a smart chute, which is going to take brass. So this is where I've ended up. This is where I need to be now. So brass needs to be copper and zinc in a mixer, and that mixer just needs a heat source, preferably a blaze burner, which I might as well just go ahead and make. So for this, I need 4 iron plates. I just pick up all nuggets? No, I didn't. Okay, so there. There. And then I can make a blaze by doing iron bars. And that fell pumpkin. But that needs to finish up one more. Because I need to be able to trap the blaze. So I need a piece of netherrack. That gets me an empty blaze burner. And then I just need to take my fell pumpkin. And I need to go 1, 2. I'm really hoping this works because I did see it in a video. That makes a blaze, and then I right-click you, and that gets me the blaze burner. Perfect. And then a smart chute. So now is where I need the brass. So I need to make a mixer, which the mixer is a cogwheel, and so a whisk is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That needs to go there. I do have enough andesite alloy to make the whisk. And I just need some more andesite casing. Which, do I have any? I don't, but I can go ahead and make more. Let's just make like 16 of them. It doesn't matter how I lay these out, because my plan is just to do this and this. Oh, that may not work then. Okay, I thought it did. But then I can do this, and that works. Okay. So is my iron done? It is. Mixer, whisk, boom, boom. And then you can live not there. Because you need a gear to... activate you. So where can I put you that I can have access to gears? I could probably still put you right there. And then can I just put a gear next to you? And then a shaft inside. And there we go. There's your mixer. That gets me a basin. That gets me all of this. And that gets me a blaze cake. Ooh, I am going places I don't need to go. Right. Create, whisk, basin. So the basin can go here. Blaze burner needs to go underneath. Blaze burner needs to go there. And I just need a way to feed you. So blaze cake, chocolate cake, and blazing arrows. Balls. Oh well. I'm sure that won't come back to bite me. Okay, so let me get rid of some junk if I can. So blaze cake. Gets them all fired up. So delicious treat for your hardworking blaze burners gets them all fired up. I don't think it's an infinite source, but I think it just burns for a long time. Because I think eventually you do have to, like, automate the creation of blaze cakes. Let me cover up this hole. That hole was not a good idea. So let me put you back. Alright, so to make bronze, which is my next step, or brass, I mean, I'm sorry, brass. So to make brass, needs, or is it bronze? What do I need? So you. You're good. You need a brass sheet. So to make a brass ingot and a mixing bowl needs to be zinc and copper ingots. So there's zinc and it's 1 to 2. It's 1 to 1. So I have 8. Let's just do it this way. We'll throw you in there, we'll throw you in there. And then blaze cake it up. Are you gonna mix? Not rotating with enough speed. Of course not, okay. So I have an idea. I'm gonna take this off. I'm gonna reconnect you to you, which means I do need to manually crank this for a little bit until it can get on its own. And then because these are moving fast enough. So if I can go here, I need some more andesite. Alloy. I need to make a few more shafts, like so. That was way more than I wanted to make, but I'll need them eventually. So then I can go from like this. Like this. I'm gonna connect you here. I need to just get rid of this for now. And then I will connect you here. Now are you spinning fast enough? Andesite alloy copper ingot. Let's go. There's no way you're not spinning fast enough. How far away do you need to be? This is a mess. Andesite alloy copper ingot. Or zinc. Oh. Alright, I'm sure all of you saw that. Thunderstorm, that means we can sleep. There it goes. Now I'm mixing it up. Alright, so that's gonna give you some brass ingots. Boom. Brass gets me a brass lantern and a zinc bee spawn egg. Nice. Alright, so then I can make brass sheets. To brass sheet is then going to get me a smart funnel or smart chute. So let me take one of these chutes off. And then we'll just come over here. And it needs an electron tube, which needs polished rose quartz, which is where I need a sandpaper. Because I know I can do this in my hand. So an iron plate. So I need rose quartz, which is a piece of quartz and redstone. Inventory issues. How do I make sandpaper? I think it's just a piece of sand and paper. Like, I'm not joking about that. I really think it's that simple of a... Yeah, it's just a piece of sand and a piece of paper. Alright, so... And I am out of sand. Or am I? Probably am. Alright, so I know there's a lot of sand in here. I just can't get it out. I hate that you can't do that. So, just really quickly, I'm just going to do that. Is blue output or is blue input? Or can you just not? There we go. Okay. All right, you can go back to doing that. All right, so sand and a piece of paper. Is going to come from sugarcane. If I have any, I do. 1, 2, 3. Sugarcane gets me a paper. That gets me sand, paper. They don't stack. Why? Why do you not stack? Because you want me to have inventory issues all the live long day. I know your game. I know what you're trying to do here. I need to make a backpack. That's what I need to do. Alright, so it was a piece of quartz, which I really hope I have. And like 8 pieces of redstone. So it was like this. Gets me a piece of rose quartz, and then one of these goes in my offhand. That gets me that. So then that gets me plus an iron plate. Gets me an electron tube. An electron tube plus a brass plate and a chute. Gets me a smart chute. Smart chute gets me some more brass sheets and some more of that. So I just need to steal my other chutes. So 3 chutes out of 4. Yep. And then I come over here and then I can make smart chutes. 1, 2, 3, 4 smart chutes. Perfect. No attached fans. What can a smart chute do that needs a fan? Smart chutes function the same, but can be filtered. Oh, fans will blow up a chute. Otherwise, gravity just pulls it down. That's what it is. Alright, so. Cool. And then quest complete on that. Brass lantern and a zinc bee. So maybe we should try to figure out what bees are all about. We could get into these. So that I don't need. Alright, so the next thing would be to get the fans and all of that going, but this looks like Create is probably going to be a 3-episode thing, because we are close to a wrapping up point. So thank you all so much for watching. I know that we're taking this a little bit at a time. I'm not purposefully trying to be slow. I am truly learning this as I go along. I know a little bit from watching other YouTubers, but I'm trying to not rely on that. So all of this knowledge is some prior knowledge, some gained knowledge, so all of this is going to just take a little bit at a time, but we will get there together. So thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you in the next episode. Goodbye!